The frightening scene happened in Jatujak, Bangkok, where a gunman opened fire inside a grocery store 7-Eleven at midnight on Thursday, June 24th. Police rushed to the scene and found the body of a 32-year-old cashier named Ratawith Santi Kupatapong lying behind the counter amid ammo shells. As witnesses said, 30 minutes before the shooting, the gunman broke bottles of beer and was not willing to pay. He went out and came back and started shooting. 3 hours later, he reached a COVID-19 field hospital located at the National Rehabilitation Center in Pathumthani Province by his white pickup truck and shot a 54-year-old COVID-19 patient named Suksan dead. Witnesses said they had heard gunshots before the culprit entered the compound and fired at will. Moments later, he fled the scene. Soon after, going inside the building was prohibited except forensic officers who were asked to wear PPE suits. The police inspected CCTVs and learned that the culprit was heading to the southern region. Later, the gunman was identified as Kwin Sang-Ninkul. He supports anti-government movement as he posted on his Facebook page. He made a stop at a shop forcing the owner for free beer and tobacco. The owner quickly posted on her Facebook page location of the culprit after he had left. He then went to his relative's house and held three people hostage. One of them is 80 years old, his grandmother. Police rushed to the house and started negotiation.
ครับสถานการณ์ในบ้านเป็นไงบ้างครับท่านมองภาพไปเลยดีฮะเดี๋ยวให้ท่านตำรวจเค้านั่นดีกว่าเพราะว่าตำรวจก็คุมสถานการณ์อย่างนี้อยู่ก็คงจะค่อยๆรอเวลาเดี๋ยวรอเจ้าที่ที่เค้ามีความเชี่ยวชาญเราเห็นภาพเลยว่ามันที่เห็นเค้ายังเดินอยู่นะ
เดินอยู่ในบ้านนี้
เดินอยู่ในบ้านก็น่าจะสงบลงเยอะนะ
ครับ
Finally, he surrendered to police after he had been pressured by the officers for 3 hours. He will be taken to the capital of Thailand for prosecution. I'm Adison Yantaran, The Fresh Stories.